Well, it's the lifeguard show. It's called Lifeguard Lessons. That's all you need to know. Well, it's the lifeguard show.
Hello. Sorry for doing that two times, but I just felt it. You know, sometimes you just feel it, and you can't stop. You don't stop when you feel it. Welcome back to the show, Lifeguard Lessons. It's been a frickin' long time, because for the past few months, we've been hibernating in the Alps, as most lifeguards do, because what else are we going to do when there's snow falling down on the beaches? Clearly, we cannot work, some might say. Why don't you go to Florida, jackass? Or somewhere else where it's warm? Well, it's not that simple. You see, Florida has their own lifeguards. I can't just be going down there with my posse and taking all the Florida lifeguards jobs, mainly because, well, aside from the fact that I'm not actually a lifeguard, they're probably in shape and big and could probably kick the crap out of me. I am back, and soon the other members of my lifeguard unit will be back with me, and we'll all be together, and we're all gonna have a great time on the show. For now, it's just me. I'm gonna give you some lifeguard training as usual. I believe we left off on chapter 6, so we're gonna pick up, start with chapter 7. I'm gonna play a few songs for you, which I hope you'll like. I hope you fancy them. Let me start now with chapter 7. Chapter 7, it's all about swimming rescues and assists without equipment. The last time we left off, I was talking to you about using equipment, buoys, if you remember. There was a lot of buoy talk and some pole things like that. So, although it is generally agreed by life-saving experts that the simplest way to effect a rescue is to extend your reach, there may be times when it is more practical to make a swimming rescue. It is at such time that judgment is the key which determines exactly what the lifeguard does. A common example of this involves a guard at a large outdoor, heavily populated pool. The guard is at his post on a permanent stand with a large canvas-covered cork ring buoy hanging alongside. The need for a rescue or an assist arises. The potential victim is not so far away that the buoy couldn't easily be tossed to him as a free-floating support. Because there are several other swimmers very close to the victim, there is a possibility that the buoy might hit and injure someone. The ring buoy is not tossed. Instead, the guard resorts to a swimming rescue without equipment, immediately following his whistle signal to alert the other guards. Now, that was a really wordy way of saying, if someone's drowning in a pool and there's a lot of other people around, don't throw a fucking buoy at them, because you're probably going to knock somebody out, then you're going to have to rescue two people, and that's just more work. And you don't get paid anymore for that, so might as well just do as little work as possible. Don't throw the fucking thing, just go swim and save them. Who wrote this thing? Good Lord. Now, there are different kinds of assists. There's the reaching assist, where you reach and grab them with your arm. And here you might be able to see, there's a drawing, the arm extension, where you extend your arm. If you don't know how to extend your arm, you probably should not be a lifeguard or human. Here is the leg extension. I would not recommend, well, you might feel fine doing it, but I don't want anyone grabbing on my feet, my ankles and shit, because that's weird. Here is everyone's favorite pole extension, where you extend your pole out into the water for the lovely little swimmer to grab a hold of and yank all the way back in. Now, here is an example of the bottom push, which basically looks to me like you put your hands on somebody's ass and push them. I wouldn't recommend that either. In this day and age, this book is a little outdated before a lot of sexual harassment laws came into play, so I wouldn't just jump into a pool or the beach and stick your hand on someone's ass and push them around. that could be taken the wrong way. There's also the underarm assist, as you can see there, the underarm assist. That's another one I'd stay away from. I don't really like touching people's armpits all that much, knowing full well what kind of funk lays under mine. I wouldn't recommend that. There's the chin toe, which basically looks like you put someone in a sleeper hold and drag them in. I'm not sure that's an effective way either. This one looks pretty good, though. The chin toe. Take a look at that one. If you can't see it, it's kind of like a bear hug sort of thing. It looks pretty effective. There's also the wrist toe on this side over here. Basically, like it sounds, they grab a hold of your wrist and tug, and possibly snap your arm out of joint.